non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, currently named as NASH, is a common, often silent, liver disease. It resembles to alcoholic liver disease, but occurs in people who drink little or no alcohol. The major feature in NASH is fat in the liver, along with inflammation and damage. Most people with NASH feel well and are not aware that they have a liver problem. Nevertheless, NASH can be severe and can lead to cirrhosis, in which the liver is permanently damaged and scarred and no longer able to work properly.
The causes of the disease, even if they are strongly correlated to obesity and excessive consumption of sugar, are, as often in metabolic diseases, multifactorial. Genetic or epigenetic predisposition are obvious, and certain ethnic groups such as Hispanics are clearly more exposed to it.
NASH is not easily diagnosed at this time, which could explain why such an epidemic has occurred without the red lights of public health flashing earlier. Currently, the only way to reliably diagnose NASH in a patient is by histological analysis of a liver biopsy. A biopsy is not a benign act, it carries a risk, can be painful, and is not very reliable. Furthermore, it is a surgical act, prescribed and accepted only when many other clinical factors indicate a serious liver problem. However, these metabolic factors are not obvious, even in advanced cases of the disease. Unfortunately, if we can only diagnose patients with advanced NASH, we will sooner or later be faced with a major unresolved public health problem.
Many laboratories have understood this and worked for many years on a multi-criteria method of diagnosis based on a set of biomarkers correlated by a computerized scoring system. GenFit Pharma, a laboratory leading the race for a treatment, advertised that their method of diagnosis, based on a set of blood biomarkers, will be available simultaneously with the placing of their drug on the market. A Spanish laboratory, OWL, has developed a serum-based NASH diagnosis using metabolomics, the AlLiver test. Another company, Exalens, is working on an original way to diagnose NASH, scanning the breath. A method named EMILI, based on magnetic resonance imaging, is also proposed, but need to be fully validated.
In 1 or 2 years, some no-invasive NASH diagnosis methods will be available and will facilitate the identification of patients needing cure.
The race for treatment started in 2012, when the Maine's health agencies, FDA and EMA, announced the public health problem they were about to face with NASH in the incoming years. Many laboratories which initially were targeting diabetes started to study the impact of their drug candidates on NASH. The NASH definition and the endpoints to reach for a future treatment was not clear. Since the beginning, NASH definition and NASH reversion endpoints required by health agencies to fulfill their criteria evolved. The initial endpoints chosen in the first studies are now considered as not relevant. This makes difficult to compare the results between studies and obliged to examine results not as a binary interpretation of the initial endpoints reached or not, but in their whole components in a way to moderate the excessive variability of liver biopsy results by the serological markers indications. This holistic approach is more relevant for a pathology, which is considered now as the liver manifestation on the metabolic syndrome.
The NASH treatment market is focused by laboratories all around the world, and almost every week, there's an article announcing the will of a laboratory to test one of their molecules on the disease. In the list you can find Intercept Pharmaceutical, GenFit Pharma, GOM Pharma, Gilead Science, Shire, Metabolic Solutions, Nimbus Therapeutics, and many others. Starting the race does not mean passing the finish line. To date, only 2 laboratories have finished their clinical phase 2B and launched their clinical phase 3, Intercept Pharmaceutical and GenFit Pharma. The drug candidates are numerous in pharmaceutical industry, statistical probability of success depend directly of the clinical phase advancement. But one should notice that success is never guaranteed for molecules in clinical trial phases.
NASH is a complex disease. Scientists are only beginning to understand the contours, and the disease definition changed with the advance of scientific knowledge. Clearly, it is the consequence of a metabolic disorder that finds its soil in fatty liver, a disease previously regarded to this day as benign, as reversible with a change in lifestyle. If we list all the most advanced laboratories having made an announcement on NASH, it seems difficult for non-specialists to evaluate the treatment strategy they promote. In the purpose of popularization, we will try to explain with analogies what are the components of the disease and who target what.
We can compare the liver steatosis with a fertile soil. Without it, the NASH disease can't prosper. On that soil, a mushroom can grow up. And we can compare the mushroom with NASH. Feet is ballooning and cap is inflammation. When the mushroom is growing up, and after a while, some spots and scars appears on the mushroom cap. The older the mushroom is, the more spots and scars increase. As an analogy, the spots and scars can be compared to fibrosis and cirrhosis.
The purpose of the demonstration is to explain what are the most advanced drugs strategy and targets. Some of the drugs are targeting mainly steatosis. They argue that removing the fertile soil will prevent mushroom to grow, and it seems logical, but what about the existing mushrooms? The most advanced drugs in this category are Arimchol from GOMD, and maybe obeticholic acid, OCA from Intercept. Some of the drugs are targeting mainly inflammation and ballooning. They argue that removing the existing mushroom and preventing new mushrooms to appear will prevent consequences, no mushroom, no scars. They target the core of the disease, the metabolic disorder. The most advanced drug in this category is elafibranor from GenFit, but drugs from Nimbus and Metabolic Solutions are also in the pipe. Some of the drugs are targeting only advanced fibrosis and cirrhosis. They act on inflammation consequences to clean the scars and spots on the cap, they preventing the liver death, but they do not impact the fertile soil and the mushroom. So, as soon they stop the treatments, the scars can prosper again. The most advanced drugs in this category are simtuzumab from Gilead, zanicrovirok from Tibira, GRMD02 from Galectin, emricasan from Conatus, and maybe OCA from Intercept. The two most advanced compounds are elafibranor from GenFit Pharma and OCA from Intercept Pharmaceutical. Those two drug candidates, if they can confirm their efficacy on NASH during their phase 3 studies, are planned to reach the market in 2019. The success of those two drugs would be an excellent news for all the patients around the world. OCA from Intercept Pharmaceutical is the first compound which presented positive results on NASH after a phase 2b. The clinical study named FLINT seems to show effects on steatosis and fibrosis, but very few effects on ballooning and inflammation, and no significant NASH reversion. In a second time, a post-hoc study, removing patients included with non-definite NASH, revealed some effects on NASH reversion. However, the design of the study presented numerous bias, and the results are still debated. Another study conducted in Japan revealed no significant effects on fibrosis and NASH reversion. So, if the OCA is still one of the promising drugs targeting NASH, it is difficult, at this time, to predict the real effects of OCA on NASH reversion. OCA also induce adverse effects like pruritus and LDL cholesterol levels increase, which is worsening of the cardiometabolic risk profile. The conclusion of the publication presenting the results of the FLINT study in The Lancet was clear.
Despite the improvements in the key features of non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, including fibrosis, these improvements were not enough to reduce the number of patients with a diagnosis of non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. The positive findings are tempered by the observation of pruritus in 23% of patients and an increase in total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, and a modest decrease in HDL cholesterol. Long-term studies are needed to confirm the beneficial effects of obeticholic acid in patients with non-alcoholic steatohepatitis.
The second compound to publish, elafibranor, from Genfit, proved, in a phase 2b clinical study named Golden, some substantial histological improvement in NASH, including resolution of steatohepatitis, and improvement of the cardiometabolic risk profile, with a favorable safety profile. Remarkably, improvements in glycemic and lipid parameters were achieved in patients already treated with conventional glucose and lipid-lowering therapies, which suggests an additional direct effect of the drug. Initially, the study was considered by many as a failure because of the spontaneous NASH resolution in mild sick patients treated by placebo. Those excessive results perturbed statistics and, in a first time, masked the indubitable efficacy of the drug. After a complete analysis of results by world's independent specialists, the conclusion of the publication presenting the results of the study in Gastroenterology is clear.
In conclusion, this randomized controlled trial provides evidence that pharmacological modulation of the PPAR-alpha-delta nuclear receptors results in substantial histological improvement in NASH, including resolution of steatohepatitis, an improvement of the cardiometabolic risk profile, with a favorable safety profile. Larger phase 3 trials of elafibranor in the target population of patients with moderate to severe NASH are warranted.
The outsiders are also in the race, but their phase 2b results are not yet published, or they are still in previous clinical phases. This animation tried to present the different stage of the race. The two leaders gained a comfortable advance. In March 2016, Genfit took the lead by recruiting its first patients in phase 3. But the race is not over yet. If all goes well, the line could be crossed in 2018, opening the way to market in 2019. To conclude, NASH is not anymore an emerging disease, but a silent pandemic disease connected to obesity and diabetes, with no approved treatment. Fortunately, diagnosis tools are in the close pipe, and treatments are just following. The large majority of patients impacted by the disease has no signs, and when the signs will be there, it will be late. If you are obese, your risk to have a NASH is from 15% to 55%. If you have a type 2 diabetes, your risk to have a NASH is from 20% to 80%. If you have a metabolic syndrome, the risk is bigger. So, as soon as the diagnostic kit will be available, if your profile is at risk, ask your physician for a test. It is the only way to know.